Welcome back to Let's Play Baldur's Gate 2, Shadows of Arm, Enhanced Edition, Blind Stuff. I'm Amethyst Lunatari, and what quest do we have to do? The Cult of the Eyeless. Sounds like a big deal. Alright, let's do this, actually. Locate an ore merchant by the name of Jerlia, who has a stall in the second tier in the southwest portion of Joaquin's Promenade. Alright, to talk to Sir Sarles. Oh, I have not to talk to him, but perform the work. 200 pounds. Well, I guess Minsk will be carrying that.
Where Minsk goes, evil stands aside.
Alright.
Jump on my sword while you can, evil. I won't be as gentle.
Our actions are good, and will serve the greater balance.
Unfortunately, we'd be behind all this stuff. Wait a second, have we ever been up... Can we go that way? Let's see. Oh, we can't. It's like falling into disrepair. We can't go any further. Alright. I guess we have to go around all this. Well, that's a damned nuisance. Sorry, guys. Ugh. Been getting these gagging coughing fits lately. Most annoying.
Oh, faster than Chiktika fast paws.
Almost as annoying as when your characters go the wrong way.
Live by the sword. Live a good long time.
A prophet? Did we ever talk to a prophet?
Pray and come with us.
Oh!
Be found worthy.
Another one of these. You, one of the faithless with your sight, bow down to the unseeing eye and acknowledge his divine majesty. You know, if they can't see, how do they know we can see? Who are you? I was once a priestess of the false Lathander. Now I am reborn to the eternal truth of the unseeing eye. Put out your vile eyes and witness the beauty of the divine. You were once a priestess of Lathander? Why would you come a preacher for this strange religion? I have been shown the way, faithless one. Lathander is nothing before the presence of the unseeing eye. Bow down. Bow down and put out your vile eyes. Who is this unseeing eye you keep mentioning? The unseeing eye is my savior and our deity. Lathander, Helm, and the rest are all but paltry and false gods before him. He who is sightless sees and knows all. Okay. Join us in bowing down to worship him and redeem the world from its sighted folly. I see. Where might I find this unseeing eye? He is everywhere, everywhere. The Master calls the name out to us, and we respond. See me now, O Great One. See your servant humbling herself before you. Never mind. Yep, the faithless. I see only faithless. Yeah, very nice. So I'm looking for this ore merchant. I said second tier.
Just like I thought it would be. Helping others and doing good things.
The ore merchant here. Okay. Wait a second. We can't get there from here. This is like something separate built on, like they didn't have enough space in all this, so they just added on some structure to it. Over here, cutter! Alright, they're gonna go up those stairs, that's fine. Except, back down. Well, oh, we can go up here. Oh, wait. Okay, I thought we were down below. These stairs are very confusing. Our characters are having a lot of trouble figuring out where the hell to go. Nice of you to join us. Jerlia, the ore merchant.
Greetings, good customer. A pearl to you.
You interested in a bulk purchase of ore? I got fine prices for masonry as well, and crafters that can build you everything from arches to overhangs. I have need of a lithium for Sir Sarles. How much would 200 pounds be worth? 200 pounds? He's mad, raving, out of his mind. So does this mean you don't have it in stock? You don't know what is involved in getting illithium. I have an agreement with a rather special source, but there's only so much I'm allowed to take. 50 pounds a season at most. Huh. So this is a fruitless enterprise then? He has sent me on a merry little chase. Hold on. It's difficult, but not impossible. There are two options to you. You can go to my source and try to pry the extra out of him, or you can use a substitute. You mean a cheaper metal as a replacement? Won't Sarles know? For all his pomp and balderdash, Sir Sarles wouldn't know quality materials if you beat him over the head with them. Now that's a fine image, huh? Enough of that. Anyway, I would wager that a derivative of illithium would serve just as well. Pure illithium is quite rare, but an alloy could be fashioned at a reasonable rate. Perhaps I should just talk to your source about the real thing. He may help. He may at that, but I will require compensation for revealing him to you. If word got out who and where my source was, I would be out of business. Make it worth my while. The ever-seeing eye would look on you favorably. Yeah, I'm sure that'll go far. Oh, not the unseeing eye. The ever-seeing eye of Helm. It's your career, so how does 500 gold sound? It sounds like the end of me for a mere pittance. No, that is not enough. So shall we discuss proper payment, or would you like to hear the substitute offer again? I don't know. Someone's going to be able to tell the difference. If not Sir Sarles, then the church, once he makes it for them. Tell me of the substitute. We have a lot of money right now, I think. Fine. If this could ruin you, I should offer no less than 1,000 gold. His name is Unger Hilldark. He stays in a copper coronet when he's in town. Don't get him mad, will you? He's had enough of a risk just coming here. He's Dwargar. Okay, I think I've seen him. I think I've talked to him. Dwargar, where does a dwarf of such evil nature find sanctuary in Am? At the Copper Coronet, of course. It hides worse than him within. Besides, they have to eat too, you know. Nothing wrong with a mutually beneficial trading agreement. He's in disguise. His kind doesn't look all that different, and as long as he's left alone, he's fine. Not a bad guy, once you get to know him. You go talk to him. Tell him I sent you. Maybe he'll let you pull a little more illithium out of him than I could get. It won't be cheap, though. Thanks. I'll do that. Good luck. You'll need it. Of course. You knew I would say that. Well, I hope this is worth it. Hope this will be worth it. I was able to get Jerlia to tell me who her illithium supplier is. He is a Dwargar named Unger Hilldark, and he's staying at the Copper Coronet, a bar in the slums district. Jerlia advises that I approach him there and ask about the ore, although she thinks it will be quite expensive. What are we doing with our lives? Okay, we're 27. I mean, oh yeah, you have all that to say, huh? I wonder if he can get up here. Look at that. Anyway, yeah, let's go talk to him.
Stand back for justice!
And I have to pay more money. That's no good. I hope this is worth it. Sheesh. Alright, slums.
See, battle bow! Run, bow, run!
Been to see a long time!
Long time, Cutter, long time. Alright, where's this guy? Unger. Unger Hilldark.
Make way, villainy! Hero coming through!
I see him! What are you staring at? Ain't illegal to be a dwarf, last I heard. Take your eyes off of me and put them somewhere else. Ah, but you're not an ordinary dwarf, are you? Not by a long shot. And I don't like your tone, boy. You got something to say? Best you spit it out before you be spending a day looking for your teeth. No need to get angry. I meant no offense. Jerlia sent me. I need illithium. She did she? Bloody hellfire. I think I'll be needing to have a chat with the lass. I trust you paid her enough that there will be some for her to split with me. She will see that it is wise to do so if the cutthroat lass knows what's good for business. You seek illithium, do you? I have none, and I'm not begin more anytime soon. Now that that is out of the way, goodbye and good riddance. It is the glory of Helm that I serve. Please reconsider. Ooh, surfacer gods. They mean little to me. May as well be for the glory of this chair I be sitting on. I could spend all day rattling off reasons why I not care for your fate or what bint you worship, but it's pointless, not even to pass the time between pints. It not matter, you blithering fool. I not have any illithium. None. It be that simple. My source is inaccessible, and if I cannot get some, I not getting it for you. Stroke your forge if you want, but it'll not do you a lick of good. You sound like this was not a planned shortage. What is the problem? Oh, so now you wish to be me friend. Out of the goodness of your heart? Found a place for one of me kind in that big soppy heart of yours? Why should I bother listen to you at all? You can't fix your problem or you would have illithium. What else can you do? Nothing. Very few opportunities for mercantile trade in this place when you are even a hill or a mountain dwarf. All right, Surfacer, you wish to share me problem? I'll give it to you. You want a lithium? You can wait for it. We mine it deep in the earth, and it'd be dangerous going. It'd be rare enough when production be normal. This all be useless information, though, because me latest shipment has yet to arrive. Me idiot brother, the gravel-brained half-wit, was to oversee the final shipment of the season, but I've not heard from him in weeks. The fool had better be dead, or I'll kill him myself. Perhaps I can help the both of us, then. If I agree to find your lost brother, and I am successful, will you provide me with the illithium I require? If you want to risk your hide for my worthless brother, then so be it. He'll likely be hiding, lurking below the surface of a temple far to the east. The fool probably caved the whole damn place down on his thick skull. Find the bastard, and I'll give you the ore. Here, I'll even show you on your map. Fine. I will do what I can to help us both. Well, that'll be later. It's probably back under the city, yeah. Unger Hilldark told me that his latest shipment of illithium has not arrived. The shipment was to be delivered by Unger's brother, Gorge? Gorgie? Gorge? But he has been missing for weeks. I've agreed to look for Gorge in the ruined temple of a dead god. And if I am successful, Unger has promised to provide me with the necessary illithium. I need a drink. Alright, so I'm not going into the city yet. Of course I will, but not yet. So we'll be taking care of that, and I assume also this. I'm not going to the Umara Hills yet. Free hair Dallas from imprisonment. Dionys Keep. Done. Windspear Hills, not going there. The Hunt for Valigar. Okay. Yeah, I'm not sure about this Valigar here. I'm assuming he's not going to be in his home, but he's going to be in the Umar Hills. This thing, I don't know if this is going to continue. Nalia's father's funeral. I messed that up. Because I was supposed to talk with her as the person talking, and I didn't. Tolgarius. If I perform the service he is asking of me. I forgot what the service is. Galen Bale. Oh, Galen Bale just wants to talk to us there. Alright, so let's go talk to Galen Bale since we're here. Galen Bale over here. We've already been there.
Butt kicking, for goodness!
I thought we talked to him again, but maybe not? Either that or the journal's just not revealing. Sorry, excuse me. Basically ran over that halfling? I think it was. Or dwarf. Greetings.
Where Minsk goes, evil stands aside.
Okay, I don't remember this person. Right, he's the one that they'll get her back for 15,000 still. If I can, like, get her back and keep the money, I'd rather do that. Bruss mentioned a new deal. Is that the change he spoke of? Aye, 15,000 gold. They wish to speed proceedings along, for your benefit and theirs. They want to keep the relationship with you as friendly as possible. So there is the final tally. Are you happy with the price? We are certainly the least offensive ally you could choose in this matter. I'm not ready to do this yet. Well, as you wishes. I can be standing here a bit longer, I can. Alright. 15,000.
Jump on my sword while you can, evil. I won't be as gentle.
Okay. Just help me remember for next time. Okay, what else? I don't remember the service, yeah, that's the problem. The Fallen Paladins. Okay, the Bridge District, led by a former knight named Anorg. Alright. Let's go find them. Storekeep.
Greetings, good customer. A pearl to you.
Why, hello, my good lord. You look like a connoisseur of fine wares with a keen eye as well. I might have a few trinkets to interest one such as you. These trinkets of yours wouldn't be stolen, would they? Stolen is such a relative concept, my lord. It's better to say that these trinkets have found their way through various means into a market that redistributes them. Spoken like a true kender. Some articles may be missed, aye, but others may not. Alas, I can only turn a blind eye and simply offer them at a fair and low price to my customers. Well then, let's see what you have. I see my eye for potential customers not failed me. Here, let me show you some of the goods I have acquired just for you. Sling plus two, huh? I like these potions. Okay. Stolen potions, maybe. Pass them down. Well, I have none. That's no good. 1 and 4. Give me this one extra one. If someone's gonna have an extra one, it's gonna be me. Off to the Bridge District to look for fallen paladins, anti-paladins, whatever you want to call them. Bridge. Now where might these people be? Looking for Anorg. I don't know if he's gonna be outside or.
Don't teach my hamster to suck eggs.
Wouldn't dream of it. Would not dream of it. On my list of things to do, that is not very high. Maybe is that one of the taverns? That guy's found oil. Oh.
Honorable men are hard to come by.
There's a lot of stuff going on here. There's a lot of people here. Reynald de Chatillon, we shall not allow you to continue your depredations here, Vindus. Take your men and be gone. Your smuggling will be tolerated no longer. Tolerated, eh? You better be able to back your words up, big man. You're gonna die trying to take my turf. We have no interest in your turf, Vindus. It is only proof of your limited mind that you think this is so. Ha! Are you trying to convince me you're still part of the Order, eh, Reynald? You think you're some kind of goody-goody paladin, huh? You know what I hear? I hear you lost your paladinhood due to some moxie that seduced and used you like a patsy. What was her name now? Celestine, wasn't it? Cool name. You know nothing of her, fool. And while I may no longer meet the Order's standards, I'll not stand by and listen to a cur such as you cheapen Celestine's name. Okay, well, as far as smugglers and fallen paladins go, might be easier to take out the smugglers.
Huh. I'll hurt you if I have to!
Creature,
and beat here. Oh, I didn't interrupt that spell. Or was it this one who cast it? One of us is stuck. Greetings to you, friend. I am grateful for your aid against these dogs and would know your name if you are willing to give it. I am Sapphire. Well met, Sapphire. I am Renal de Chatillon, once of the Order and now under the leadership of Anarch. Might you be interested in employment? How did you come to leave the Order, if I may ask? There are several of us here who, for one reason or another, are unworthy of the vows we once took. We do not share the particulars of our downfall. Well, they're fighting smugglers, so they can't be all bad, right? I would not expect one who has not fallen to understand. We seek the solace of each other's company because we come from the same place. Regardless, we find ourselves in need of aid, and you fight well. Might you be interested in helping us? I might be. As for the task, when Anarch left the Order, the Paladin stripped his cup from him. The cup is important to him. Perhaps you could retrieve it. Where will we find this cup? Find the most noble Order of the Radiant Heart in the Temple District. The cup is within their building. We shall be rewarded admirably for its return. We'll go now and retrieve this cup for you, although it hardly seems a test of our abilities. You'd best be prepared. The Order is strongly defended. I myself would die quickly if I stepped near their hall. I wish you well, my lady. Wow. So we're supposed to investigate these people, and now we have a task to do for them. How's that work? I have spoken to Renal de Chatillon, a member of the Fallen Paladins, who promises to introduce me to Anarch if I can get a hold of a cup that belonged to Anorg and is still in the possession. He did say that? I don't remember him saying he's going to introduce me to Anorg if I get a hold of this thing. If I get a hold of a cup that belonged to Anorg, it's still in the possession of the Order. The cup, it seems, is largely ceremonial, but important to Anorg personally. Well, my. Okay.
Live by the sword. Live a good long time.
I just gotta wait for one member to be free. Okay, once that's gone, I want to talk to them. I'm probably not gonna say much. Oh, the cat! The cat's got stuck. Just hang out, kitty. It's gonna be better soon. What's that, Nalia? I can't hear you. Yeah, you're walking right into us. How are you? Worn out boots. Huh. Interesting. Oh. We actually have a scroll of invisible stalker. A potion or oil of speed and two potions of invisibility. Cool. Okay, Aerie can learn that one. Oil of speed. Give that to Minsk. You can stack that there and a lot of potions of invisibility. I hate to give it to him because he needs a little more room. Agility. Let's trade. You get that, and I get this. You need another potion bag. Yeah, that'll help a little bit. Plus one. Okay. All right then. An Airy attempting to learn invisible stalker. And done. She already has one of these wands. Wait. We need some cures here. Oh, she already learned it, that's right.
In Baravan's name, it shall be done.
You return, my lady, but you do not have Anorak's cup with you. Is something amiss? Sorry, I'm on my way to do it now. Excellent. I shall see you anon. Yeah, we have not moved. Let's see what these guys have to say.
Declare yourself!
Those fools of the most noble order of the Radiant Heart are so full of themselves.
Declare yourself! Declare yourself!
The most noble order of radiant farts are pathetic. I guess I'll go along with it. Yes, I've never seen such a clumsy bunch of morons in my life. Morons indeed!
Declare yourself!
Finally, I can enjoy life without those oppressive paladins breathing down my neck. Alright.
Stand back for justice!
Alright, so I'm still investigating them. I'm like going undercover by getting this thing. I'm not completely sure if we're gonna go there right now to the most noble order of the Radiant.
Our actions are good, and we'll serve
not
the
farts. But the Radiant Heart. Well, we shall see. Next episode, more hijinks and tomfoolery will be going on. Thanks so much for watching, guys. See you next time, and always seek adventure.